Hello dear Steemians, Dtubers, and all beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpy, and this is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. At the very beginning, I want to let you know, or actually to announce somehow, that Myra public release was launched. So Myra is launched, and you can find those news about Myra or Myra on the page of @steemitblock. So it is, in my view, a very significant announcement regarding relating to our Steem blockchain, because this is some kind of, let's say, innovation or update on the top of Steem blockchain that will help steemit.inc to reduce its cost to support the infrastructure. You can have a look at their news. You can have a look at those news about Myra, and it seems that it may really help Steemit Inc. and all other developers and witnesses and nodes to store almost all necessary data on low costs. So it is a significant improvement that can reduce the costs that are needed to be paid to support the infrastructure of Steem blockchain. So I'm very happy if everything will go smoothly with Myra or Myra, and those are some positive news in my view about Steem blockchain. Now let's move to the prices of the major cryptocurrencies. That's why I will use the site on CoinGecko, and according to CoinGecko, Bitcoin is trading at the level of $8,327, and I would like to comment on the price chart of Bitcoin, because yesterday the price of Bitcoin reached the psychological level of $9,000. So actually, let's have a look at the price chart, and this is how it looks like. Yesterday the price of Bitcoin just for a few minutes reached the level of, it is here, $9,074 according to the site of CoinGecko, and almost immediately after that the price of Bitcoin drops significantly to levels close to 8,000. So that was some really very solid and fast movement. The price of Bitcoin reached 9,000 and then dropped to 8,000 just within a few minutes. And of course, many people now try to explain or to analyze what the reason behind this solid fluctuation was, why the price of Bitcoin couldn't break through the level of $9,000 and stay over that level. I have watched some interviews for the last, let's say, 5 or 6 hours, then I read some news. Some experts, they claim that it was just some of the investors in Bitcoin, they decided to close their long positions to fix their profits, and they try to assign some different kind of explanations to this price fluctuation. But I don't agree with most of them, because some of them claim that this is because of geopolitical factors, because of the trade war between USA and China. For me, this is some kind of nonsense. I don't think that this movement on the price chart can be explained by the trade war between USA and China. Also, some other people claim that it was because of the conference, or the upcoming conference consensus in New York. I also don't think that this movement has something to do with, or anything to do with, this consensus conference. Some other experts claim that this movement can be explained by some regulatory issues in the United States, that some regulatory institutions or bodies decided to take some steps in the United States in regard with some ETFs or some futures or some regulations on Bitcoin. I think it's complete nonsense, because United States, yes, it is a big market, but it is not that significant market for the whole blockchain or cryptocurrency world, because USA is just a piece of the globe, and I don't think that some regulatory bodies in the United States can impact this global market. It's not to, if it was, for example, the New York Stock Exchange, definitely the decision of the SEC and other regulatory institutions or bodies in the United States, they have significant impact on those markets, but on the price chart of Bitcoin, I think it's a kind of nonsense, because I may say that the regulatory body in Argentina decided to do something in regard with Bitcoin, and now this is the fluctuation on the chart that we see is due to these regulations in Argentina. It's really a little bit funny to claim such kind of things. That's why I just want to comment now on the price chart, and that's why let's have a look at some candlesticks. For example, what makes me happy is if we switch to 1 week chart, I see, or we can see, that at least the local high and the local low within this week are still higher than the local lows and local highs of the previous weeks. So we still have this bullish pattern, but it means that we're in these levels close to 8,000, 9,000 or a little bit higher. There is some kind of resistance, and actually in my view this is this resistance, just the levels at the that are at the levels that describe, let's say, that high. So at that high we have, at the levels of that high we have this resistance level, and I think that we will make some kind of consolidation, but I am still bullish on the price of Bitcoin, and think that we will see probably levels a little bit higher again. So I'm happy that the last candlestick at least has a local low, even after that fluctuation, yesterday's fluctuation, higher than the previous one. If we switch to the price chart of Steam is trading at 43 cents 0.26, according to CoinGecko. The price dynamic is also not that negative, because yes, on a 1 day chart we're in this downtrend, we have this sequence of descending highs and descending lows, but recently we can say that we're in some kind of consolidation, so the price of Steam is trading sideways on a 1 day chart. If we have a look at the price chart on a 1 week time frame, what makes me happy is that, as on the price of Bitcoin, we see that after the solid price fluctuation or volatility that took place yesterday, at least the local low is still higher than the local low of the previous week. So it means that still there is some kind of support, and probably we may see continuation of this rebound in the coming days. So I'm still a little bit more bullish rather than being bearish on the price of Steam. That's it for today, fellas. Thank you for watching. I wish you a wonderful day and hope to see you in my next video. That was me at CryptoSpark.